Oh, there I am. Hey, this is Sean. What's going on? I thought I'd go on Mid Journey, do some renders. This one took about, I don't know, maybe 20 seconds to make four images. All I did was type Michael the Archangel, and it gave me these four pictures. This is like, I guess this would be the base to work from. I didn't tell what version of the AI to use. I didn't tell what style to use. Just typed in Michael the Archangel. And it spits out these guys. I mean, look at the detail on this thing. I don't know which one. I haven't really looked at him yet. I just did this like, I don't know, 5 minutes ago. Took me longer to set up my video recorder than to do these renders. Okay, so now now that I'm looking at the pictures, I'm starting to see some things. The hand is having trouble holding this. The fingers aren't right. These fingers are jacked up. Maybe I need to tell it what version of the AI to use, because I know the fingers have been fixed. This doesn't look too bad. It's like in Westworld, you can tell by the hands if someone's a robot or not. Okay, what else is wrong? What else? How are the feathers doing? Feathers, I mean, how hard can feathers be? Copy paste, copy paste. They seem to have light behind their head in all of these. Kind of cool. I just have to figure out a way to prompt Midjourney. This is my plan. I'm out of practice with Midjourney, but what my plan is for Midjourney to render like a bathroom, modern, what they call it, international style, post, what they call it, maybe not post, just modern international style house, bathroom. Meaning there's an atrium. So one of the walls in the bathroom is glass. So you see through the atrium into the rest of the house on the other side of the atrium because all the walls are glass facing the atrium. And there's this guy. This is in the 1950s. So Michael the Archangel, he's going to be a 1950s dude, buff, shirtless. He's got pants on. He's relaxing, kind of, sort of, in his little house, his little Eichler house. And his car's in the carport. There's no garages back then, it's just carports. And I guess he's got some cuts, wounds on his shoulders, on his back. He's got some blood. He's taken off his t-shirt and it's kind of blood stained. And then he's got all of his weapons, not swords so much, but maybe just horrendous stuff, buzz saws, chainsaws, Gatling guns, some knives maybe, just guns. He's gonna have lots of guns. He's not using swords so much. He's using guns. So he's gonna have all kinds of guns laying out, sprawled out somewhere. I don't know. Maybe they need cleaning too. But the thing is, he'll be looking down at his bathtub, just a regular, the old ceramic style bathtubs. With the four legs on them and a curtain thing, some sort of a curtain. And the curtains are open, but there's blood on the curtains too. Inside the bathtub is water. He's got some water going and he's putting his weapons in the bathtub and the blood's coming off the weapons. So the water in the tub's kind of getting bloody colored looking. And this is after, I guess, a night on the town. basically this is the next morning. Maybe he's getting up, getting ready to go back to his work. He has to put on some fresh clothes, take a shower, but his weapons are in the bathtub, so I don't know. He's debating what to do next. And the thing is, I want him to look like a character from Mad Men. From late 50s, early 60s, that era. So he's got to have that haircut. He'll be wearing those glasses, you know, the Clark Kent NASA glasses, you know. He'll have those on. And no, none of his neighbors know that he's the Archangel. None of them know what he does for a living. Someone in the neighborhood might think he's a hitman. Works for the CIA. When he goes outside, he's wearing the typical 50s suit that all guys wore back then. With the handkerchief in his pocket. Looking very debonair. Very Mad Men. You know, in Mad Men, they all wore suits, right? At least in the earlier seasons when it took place in the 50s. That would be cool. I want to show players this. The image. And it'll take them right. They'll be right in the city. Using Mongoose Traveler 2nd Edition rules. I don't know where yet where his house is. If he's in San Francisco, Los Angeles, New Mexico somewhere, Flagstaff, San Antonio. I kind of envision him being out in the hot desert somewhere, like in Texas. Like that's where the demons would be, in the desert, in hot desert. Places that, like Death Valley, that would be perfect to have. Demons and crap. They hide in the hot deserts where humans don't go, but at night they can come out and head towards populated cities, you know, Las Vegas, that kind of thing. But Las Vegas kind of already, that's sort of a trope. I mean, Las Vegas has been done to death as far as vampires and stuff are concerned. So I'm trying to think of a town. Hasn't really been used all that much for a role play session. Because when the towns are original, the players think of original things to do. Instead of, oh, this is Las Vegas? Well, I'm going to go on, you know, I'm going to go to this casino or the strip or the whatever. I'm going to Excalibur. I'm going to New York. I'm going to Paris, you know. I'm going to the Star Trek experience at the Hilton. You know, those kinds of nonsense. You know, I want the players to, they'll have to look around the town. They'll like explore things, especially if they can go on Bing and do street maps and go on street level and look around to get a gist of what the place looks like. But beyond that, they don't know what they're going to do. Anyway, so that's what I'm doing probably this weekend. But I thought it was interesting. My first shot, just doing a prompt of Michael the Archangel, came up with this. All on its own. I mean, not all on its own. I mean, it's got tons and tons and tons of Bing images and crap to look through. But it's like, something tells me that there was Dark Souls or Skyrim mods had an influence on this AI artiste. Now, if I do Frazetta style, that will be something. Then we're gonna, because this is just the base. This is just a base. You know, Michael has this effeminate look about him, which is fine. Because angels don't have sexes, do they? Or genders, I should say. Can't say the word sex anymore. Anyway, I'll let you guys go.